So here's a way to take advantage of the built-in automated backups of the individual containers, rather than trying to back up the entire Appdata directory. So essentially, most of these containers, like LiDAR, Sonar, Radar, they have paths built in for doing their own backups, and that normally goes /config/backups. So just like so. And essentially what I've done here is I've created an additional host path, host path 03, and that redirects that folder to a folder that I've created in the Appdata share called ours. Now, in hindsight, I should have named this something more contextually appropriate, such as database backups. That would be better if you're going to do this yourself. So I've redirected config/backups to this subfolder inside ours. Now, what does that allow me to do? In essence, if I was to go and backup the entire Appdata folder, that would use far too much space. I don't need the assets that a lot of these generate, which is mostly posters and thumbnails and album covers and movie covers, so I can bypass all that and still have an effective backup, but using less time and less resources. So let's take a look. So in order to do this, I go to Community Applications, Backup and Restore, which is an application just here. I open it up, and that takes me to the configuration page. So what I've done is I've set all the applications that allow this feature to backup their databases to that folder and their own subfolder within that. So all these applications here that are set to not stop during backups, those are all doing this. Also here, I need to set that these applications are excluded, which I have done so previously. So here we've got Bazaar, LiDAR, Radar, Sonar, all here and all excluded. And also I have excluded the applications that I do not want to backup. One of these is Mylar, the other is Calibre. And here, use compression, I have disabled. Frankly, I don't see very effective compression done on this. It seems like a bit of a waste. I prefer to leave it off. Also, I have created separate subfolders for each one. It makes it much easier to roll back a change or recover from data loss. And if I was to go to backup and restore right now, it shouldn't take me long. So here it is running, and it's going to roll through and shut down the individual apps, do a backup of the subfolder, and it will pop that backup into a cache-only share that I've created, which is called backups, and then its own subfolder for CA backups, along with the libvirt image and USB. Keep in mind that USB backup is deprecated, so you should probably use my servers or figure out some other backup strategy, but I'm using it still. Now let's take a look at the outcome. So here we are in Microsoft Edge, and here we have the original backup that I did, where I backed up everything apart from Plex. And that came out to a total of 86.6 gigabytes. If I take a look at the other backup that I did, where I just excluded more things that weren't totally necessary, it comes out to 33.5 gigabytes. And if we take a look at the backup that I did prior to making this video, it should come out to 7.6 gigabytes. Witnessing some I/O latency because the backup is ongoing and it's writing to this directory. I'm just going to take a look at the system. A Okay, so it's still backing up those files. I'll just give it a minute. And now I believe it's validating that the backups were done successfully. No, my mistake, it's restarting the applications. Let's take a look at the dashboard. Okay, it seems to have eased off a little bit. Okay, the backup is completed. Let's take a look at File Explorer. And here, if I just refresh the page, we see we have a new backup. But let's take a look at the older one, just to validate that everything's okay. So all these things selected, that's 8.74 gigabytes. And if we look at the one that we just did right now, so that's 8.72 gigabytes. So the backups seem to be working as they should, and that's a whopping 90% reduction in terms of backup space required. And now I do also have the benefit of having my Plex database backed up. Now you could use this for a couple things. You could make more frequent backups that once running don't shut down certain Docker applications, so you'll get more uptime. Or you could just use it to save space. Anyways, I hope this was helpful. Take care.